Well, I'm staying ready to work closely with you as you get to the Senate floor with it. Okay. Well, listen. Well, good to talk to you, and again, my congratulations. And with both our commitments to real tax reform, I think this can be a banner year for the people of this country. Well, now you just go out there and win that primary. Okay. All right.
It's not bad.
Oh, well, I think it does. If it did go, that would be good.
Well, no, no.
Yeah. It's 12:30 at night in Tokyo. Still not back. I want to tell you, last night I began falling asleep before dinner. So we went to bed right after dinner, and of course, you know what happened. Yes. When it got to daytime and their time over there, we were both wide awake for hours this morning. We haven't had a trying to persuade Nancy that we must not yield to a nap or anything today, so that tonight we could maybe through sheer fatigue get back on our time. Yeah, well, listen, the trip was a great success. I think the best of the six that I've attended, and there were people that have been attended more than six, out of the 12 that have been held so far, and said they had never seen one as good. A united front on all the major issues, and a lot of discussions, and some differences here and there. They never got down to any digging into the heels or anything. Also in Indonesia, I think we strengthened our relations with the ASEAN nations, although I am worried about President Suharto. Because, as you know, 13,600 islands scattered over 3,000 miles, that's Indonesia. And their only means of having communication, being able to pick up a phone and talk from island to island and so forth, is by way of a satellite. You can imagine what a network of cables it would take if you didn't have a satellite. And their satellite has been up there for a while, and it's actually tilted a little or something. They're aware of that, so they've been counting on that we, with the next shuttle, we're going to put their satellite, another satellite, in space for them. Now with that all delayed because of the Challenger tragedy, why, I told him that we hoped that before the end of the year we would be able to put it up, and probably with a Delta missile. And he was most pleased and happy when he left me, but a day later, our Delta blew up, and I'm afraid he might be over there drinking himself into a stupor. But, they were good meetings, and they all took a constructive approach. They're eager to keep relations with us on a sound footing, and they really are dedicated to carrying on and trying with the Cambodian thing to end this Vietnamese domination there, simply because of what it means, Soviet power in the area. And so the summit, well, as you can imagine, we're very pleased with the thing on terrorism. It looked for a moment as if there might be some opposition when the statement was all finished and everyone agreed on everything, except that I brought up the matter that we hadn't mentioned Libya, and we thought at least Libya ought to be in there, specifically mentioned. God bless her. Margaret Thatcher rose to the issue, and so did Brian Mulroney, and we had it in there. I told them as proof, I said, if we don't, I said, that's the first question the press is going to ask. Why didn't we mention Libya? And we finished and went out on the grounds for the tea house there for lunch. And the first question yelled from the press was Sam Donaldson said he must have gotten a glimpse of the statement, the working statement, before we finished it. And he said, how come no mention of Libya?
I said, Sam, you're
late. But I was very pleased because all the other heads of state were with me and they all heard that the first and only question from the press, what about Libya? Other things I must say here, Margaret Thatcher was just great. She incidentally visited your troops in Korea, went up to Panmunjom, and proudly showed me what the military gave her. One of those blue beaked caps with scrambled eggs on the beak, the bill, and on the top of the cap it says, Iron Lady. The accident cover-up by the Soviets, I think we took a good stand on that. And Margaret incidentally told me that in Britain, our Challenger tragedy has been revived by the people in discussions, and they're using it as a contrast of the right way and the wrong way, that we immediately, the very same day, went on the air with a complete explanation of all that had taken place. And the English people in their conversation are contrasting that to the Soviet Union's attempt to cover up on their accident. So there's a little less anti-Americanism over there. The economic discussions were excellent. The Allies agree our policies for sustained non-inflationary growth have worked. And they have a broad agreement, or we have a broad agreement for multilateral trade round. And finally got what for 2 years we've been trying to get, a specific time in which we're going to get at the GATT rounds. We set that as September for the ministers' meeting in September. All in all, I think it was the best trip that we've had. But now I think they're calling Don and John. I don't know if you've worked out who goes first on two major issues and for briefing on this.
Thank you. Hey, Bob.
Hi, guys.
How's it going?